When a word ends in a consonant sound and the next word begins with the same sound, we blend the sounds and pronounce them as one. This is really cool because I feel like this is something that has a really big impact, not only on your pronunciation, but your confidence with fluency. Because once you understand, oh, that's why it sounds so different, or that's why I could never pronounce it that way, it's because you were trying to force two sounds when we were only using one. This will also feel really good when you start recognizing it when you listen to native speakers. I think this will help you feel like you can understand them more easily and just be a part of the conversation instead of constantly trying to understand them word for word. Okay, so the first example, what's your phone number? So the emphasis is on pho-num-ber. So instead of phone number, pho-num-ber. Now again, this is another great example. Perfect the pronunciation of phone, silent E at the end. There's a whole section about silent E's in this course because it's something that makes a big difference. If you're pronouncing the E, phone-y, you won't link it. You won't do the continuous consonant because it's a totally different sound ending. Phony number, right? Like there's no possibility for the kind of blending that we're doing. So first we perfect phone, silent E, phone. Then you take the N and at the end of phone, the N at the beginning of number, and we blend it and only pronounce it once. Phone number. Phone number. What's your phone number? Now listen to the rhythm. And by the way, again, this is a question. When you're asking for someone's phone number, it's probably a relaxed question. So I want your body, like right now, shake out your shoulders and just feel casual. Because if you look intense when you're asking for someone's phone number, oh my goodness. I mean, they're not going to want to give it to you, especially if it's like a romantic interest. So we want to relax. Imagine yourself asking maybe a new colleague that you need to communicate with. If you're not married, maybe think about meeting someone who speaks English and you're romantically interested in them and you want to get their phone number. Maybe you're just meeting someone that you think would be a cool friend when you're traveling. All right, so again, what's your phone number? What's your phone number? So I did it differently because context. Maybe you're getting different people's phone number. So if that's the case, I would emphasize your. What's your phone number? Right? Like now it's your turn. In general, what's your phone number? What's your, reduction. Instead of your. What's your phone number? Phone number. Now I go back up at the end of number because it's a question. And lastly, what's your phone number? Okay, next. Can I have some more? All right, so here we have again, oh my goodness, I'm so excited. Silent E, so instead of some-y, it's some. So it ends in mm. More begins with mm. So we blend it, some more. Notice that it's a suh. Some more. So it's a slight emphasis on the first syllable, suh. And then can I have? So listen for that reduction, kun, kun. And then we have the N sound, which links to nai, can I, can I. Can I have some more? Can I have some more? Okay, so even though we have some, suh, more, I go up at the end because it's a question. Try it. All right, can I have some more? And again, remember, visualization is really powerful. When you're just reading a sentence, it tends to be a little stiff. You're just reading out loud. So the reason I use so many short sentences for this advanced course is because I want them to be easy enough for you to not look at the page, not look at your notes, and just look at the camera, look at your phone, whatever you're using to record, and just say it. So right now, look at your phone or your camera and say, can I have some more? Visualize yourself. You're traveling abroad, you're in a delicious restaurant, and you want some more, I don't know, coffee or spaghetti, whatever. put yourself in a context that makes you feel relaxed, this kind of question, you're going to be extra polite. You're probably going to smile. Can I have some more? Maybe we add please. Can I have some more, please? Good. Remember, imagine yourself being somewhere, whether it's real life or imaginary, whatever works for you, and that will help your intonation training. Next, the North thought they were right. Okay, so for those of you who maybe don't love the TH sound yet, because you will, I have a whole section about TH sounds. There are actually two sounds. We have voiced and unvoiced, but you'll learn that later. The important thing here is when it's the same TH, they blend. So instead of having to pronounce the TH twice, it's just once. The North thought they were right. So here I'm thinking of the Civil War in the US, where North versus South. The North thought they were right. So the North, notice I go up a little bit, I emphasize nor. The North thought they were right. Remember, intonation. If you sounded like this, the North thought they were right. If you go up at the end, that's going to sound like you're questioning the statement. If you told me that, the North thought they were right, I would answer you like, oh yeah, or no, or are you asking me or telling me? So if this is something you experience in real life, now you know why. So bring it back down at the end. The North thought they were right. They were right. Oh, by the way, here, they were right. We have and er. So actually that's another example of continuous consonants. So we have the R sound in were and the sound in right. So they were right. Good stuff, huh? It's like a bonus. All right, good work.